said it's time to find a job and don't have to tell you about the market being so tough right now. There is a glimmer of hope for new grads. Employers are planning to make 5% more job offers this spring than they did in 2009. Our workplace contributor Tori Johnson is here with the five things college grads should do right now to get that job they want. Okay, let's go ahead and help them again. Because you talked to 2009 grads who, boy, that was such a tough time to be out looking for a job. And when you talked to them on graduation day, they didn't have a job, but they were able to get one.
That's right. So we're going to tell you what they did, and if they could do it, anybody could do it. So the first is, you know, everyone hears networking, networking, networking. You got to network. But for somebody who's inexperienced at it, they often show up at events, wander aimlessly, and it's a bust. And Chris Cookson, who graduated from Oregon State, decided he was going to take a different tactic. He attended events that were specific to his own industry. And what that meant was that he was walking into an event where everybody was employed in the field that he wanted to be in already. Mm-hmm. And it enabled him to make connections, which connected him ultimately to his next employer, his current employer. And he's now hired just 2 months after graduation as a project manager for a medical research firm. And the lesson really from Chris is that you have to attend events. And when you do, to be face-to-face, put a face to your resume, you want to bring business cards, have your spiel ready, go alone so you don't cling to your pal, but you're forced to talk to other people. And along the same lines about making that face-to-face connection, Anthony Lopez is somebody else who I was so excited to talk to because he graduated, got sick and tired of hearing no response from all of his online applications, decided to show up in person. He went to the hospital that he wanted to work for, to the HR department, and that's what ultimately got him hired because he showed up not just to grab an application, but to make a face-to-face connection when he went into that office. And the lesson really from Anthony is, there are certain industries, not all, where you can show up face to face to grab that application, whether it is retail, hospitality, many hospitals. And if there's an HR department that accepts walk-ins, go in not just, you know, in schlubby clothes, ready to like grab an application, but instead to make that contact, to put a face to your resume, to encourage somebody to get to know you a little bit, to find out what the process is.
So many people feel like if they can just get that face to face, they'll be able to do and land that job. You also talk about go for that temp position. Of course, you want the permanent position.
That's right.
But go for the temp.
A temp job's often a way in the door. And so, for example, I talked to a woman named Caitlin Corinne, and in her case, she wanted to work in the entertainment industry. So she not only targeted positions, but also companies. And she found out that one of the companies on her target list had a temp job. Not the one that she wanted, not the dream job in marketing that she wanted, but something she was perfectly capable of doing. So she decided to accept that temp job and then network relentlessly internally, and ultimately, after the temp job was finished, was transferred internally to the full-time position that she has now. And so another success story by getting her foot in the door. So when you're pursuing temp work, the lesson that we learned from Caitlin is think about the company, not only the position, because once you get in there, often you can maneuver your way around.
These are great lessons that we're learning from them. Now, this next one is a little bit tricky. An unpaid internship.
Yeah.
You know, there are a lot of folks that says that they can't afford
afford it. No one graduates from college wanting to work for free, but it certainly beats sitting on the couch. And so in the case of Candace Thompson, she wanted to work in the competitive entertainment industry and decided that she'd take an unpaid internship and wait tables simultaneously. So she got industry experience and was able to pay the bills. That combination ultimately impressed her current employer, where she landed a staff position full-time on the payroll at an entertainment company, all because she chose to put that experience on her resume. And that's so important.
Wow.
Better than sitting on the couch and having nothing to show
that time. And the final one, use your college services and connections.
Yes, career services. You've paid all this money for it.
Yeah.
Gabby Cobb used her alumni connections to get her current job. And really, make a list of 50 alumni connections that you can have. And one, two, five of them might not call you back, but all you need is that one. So even if you make those three calls and nobody calls you back, keep going down the list.
I got to tell you, Southeastern Louisiana grads are not shy about calling me. Hear from them all the time and happy to do it.
Good, right?
I love it. I really appreciate that. And that's right. They're using that connection.
Are you about to give out your phone number now?
No, I won't. We'll leave that to you,
that's
Tori.
Next.
Because she is the woman. I can't help you as much as this woman can here. And she'll have more of her tips for grads on our job hunt on our website at abcnews.com. And I mean that sincerely. Tori is just relentless, and she's always on the web. She's always providing answers and services, so please do that. I'm not trying to get out of it. I just know that you're better suited.
Are you scared about starting your life at that school?
A little bit, yeah. I'm not gonna lie. It's like when I first graduated, when it was all sinking in, it was just kind of all came into my mind at once. I just pretty much had like a nervous breakdown, but it's not as scary of a thought as it was initially. It kind of helps with Amy being there for me as well, so that helps.
Absolutely. I've had school kind of to help me stay calm, help me, you know, get ready for the real world, and now that it's so close, it's a scary thought, it really is. I mean, I'm looking forward to the job hunt, and I'm looking forward to starting my future, but it's definitely scary.
I am decently scared about my life without school. I'm gonna miss all my friends, and it's scary to think about the responsibility that I'm gonna have to take on with finding a job and paying my bills, and you know, I won't be able to goof around anymore and sleep in.
I'm terrified about starting my life at school, but I applied to 4 different grad schools. You have to have your doctorate to be licensed as a physical therapist now. So basically I can't do anything with my bachelor's degree from here. I have to go on to school. So knowing that I'm not leaving here in 7 days and I have to find a job and I have to start my life right now is actually kind of reassuring, because I enjoy school. So I have 3 more years of grad school, but I'm really nervous about getting into my grad schools. So,
which schools did you apply to?
I have applied to Northeastern University in Boston, which is my top choice. I've applied to Husson in Bangor, Maine, UVM in Burlington, and Clarkson University in New York.
In conclusion, graduating seems to be a stressful yet happy time. You're very lucky if you get a job, because you're competing with people that have graduated 1 to 2 years ahead of you. And the best way it seems to be able to get that job is to either get an unpaid internship or get a smaller position in a company that you wish to work for and move your way up. Also, you might not get your dream job, so you have to get the temporary job in order to provide for yourself. This seems very strange, considering we're told we go to college, we'll almost always get a job, and hopefully this will improve within the next 1 to 2 years.